I woke up thinking you were still here. My hands shaking with regret. I've held this dream for such a long, long time, and I wanna get up to the rhythm of a wild, to the rhythm of a wild heart that beats like a rolling drum. Saw you standing on the corner. I saw you standing on your own. And I get the feeling that it's all a dream. And I wanna get up to the rhythm of a wild, to the rhythm of a wild heart that beats like a drum. When I fall asleep, I can see your face. What I lost in you, I will not replace.
Standing on your own. I guess. get the feeling that it's all a dream. I don't wanna get up to the rhythm of a wild, to the rhythm of a wild heart. The beat like a drum.
When I fall asleep, I can see your face. What I lost in you, I will not replace. And I could run away, I could let them down, but I will remember your light.
Your light, it follows me in darkness. I'm trying hard, but I can't win. I've played the victim for a long, long time. I don't wanna grow up from the rhythm of a young, from the rhythm of a young heart. It leads us like a river wounds. At night I send over the parkway. The summer's gone and now I'm alone. And I get the feeling close. And I wanna get up to the rhythm of your wild, to the rhythm of your wild heart. It beats, been beating since you're gone.
When I fall asleep, I can see your face.
You're standing on your own. And I get the feeling that it's all a dream, and I wanna get up to the rhythm of your wild, to the rhythm of your wild heart. It beats like a drum. When I fall asleep, I can see your face. What I lost in you, I will not replace. And I could run away, I could let them down, but I will. Follows me in darkness, trying hard, but I can't win. I've played the victim for a long, long time. And I want to roll from the rhythm of the young, from the rhythm of the young. The heart, it leaps just like a river runs. Tonight I sit over the parkway. This summer's gone and I'm alone.
And I get the feeling that you're somewhere close. I don't wanna get up to the rhythm of your wild, to the rhythm of your wild heart. It beats since you've gone. When I fall asleep, I can see your face. What I lost in you, I will not replace.
Dreams aren't random.
A lot of times for me, dreams are way more feeling than a dream.
Mm-hmm.
There's three main dreams / feelings I have. But the main one I have is I'm somewhere and it's totally nondescript. And so it can be different. It can be like different places, but I'm somewhere and nothing is going on, so I'm just in a room and I don't see anyone, but there, I always know it's a person. So for example, it could be my mom, or it could be a friend or someone I work with or something like that, but they're not there, so I'm not ever face to face. And it's just this very, very subtle feeling where I'm in a completely nondescript place. I literally can't even describe it. It's not like in the clouds,
right?
It's not white walls, it's not black walls, it's just in the dream there's no place. All I know is that something is terribly, terribly wrong. I can never see the person or place where I am, but I know who it is. And it's just something is like deeply, deeply wrong.
But it's not specific what the thing is.
It's completely not specific. I can never figure it out. Mm-hmm. And when I wake up from that dream, which I have probably once a week, it can take me anywhere from a few hours to the rest of that whole day to get out of it. And it's like that feeling, like, you know, when you get terrible news and then you forget it for a second, mm-hmm. and you know something's horribly wrong.
Right.
And then you remember, oh, it's because there was that terrible earthquake, right. or so-and-so just got cancer or whatever. Mm-hmm. It's that feeling all day. So that's one main dream.
Okay.
The second dream is a little bit more of a specific version of that dream. I've cheated on my girlfriend. And I didn't want to. And I'm not having sex in the dream. There's no, like, pleasure component that, right. I feel bad about. It's just, once again, this feeling. I'm somewhere. I'm nondescript. I cheated. I wish I didn't, but I can't change it. And that one is, like, super potent. I'll wake up with it, and I'll be like, I ruined everything. So those two are the main ones. And then maybe, like, once every 6 months, I'll have this other kind of dream, which is really what the song is about. So I lost, my sister was born with brain cancer. Uh-huh. She died when I was 18. 12 years ago, wow. Time. And I have this dream, which is super, super specific. I'm with my sister, who's not here anymore. And we're not doing anything specific, but there's just this, like, there's this vague feeling that everything is okay. She's there. It's extremely real. She's the way she was. She's 13, which is when she died. She's that age. And then what's crazy about those dreams is when I wake up from those dreams, which is really what the song is about, there's this period of time, which I'm really mm-hmm. focused on, fascinated yeah. about, where it's probably, in reality, it's probably 5 seconds, but it feels like 1,000 years, right as I'm leaving the dream, mm-hmm. and right as I'm fully becoming conscious that I'm in reality.
Right.
And that 5 seconds is like, for these dreams specifically, when I'm dreaming about my sister, mm-hmm. I'm in reality, but she's not dead. And it's the most powerful experience ever. Because my entire life is based on, I feel like, in different people's lives, really intense defining things happen. And so for me, that was, you know, by far the most defining thing that's ever happened in my life. So everything I do, if I, like, drink a glass of water, if I walk down the street, I'm doing that as someone who lost my sister. That's just, it's like who I am. It's like being Jewish or 6 feet tall, or it's just like a defining feature of myself. And so in that split 5 seconds, I'm not that, and it's like I'm literally a totally different person.
Essentially, in that dream where you're with your sister and she's that age,
yeah.
you actually are transporting yourself back to yourself with her before she died.
Really?
Yeah. So it's you're in your psyche, you're that person. We can sort of time travel in our dreams, and we often do. So you're that person, which means it feels like that. You are that person before she died, and before that defined who you were.
I feel like I'm less complicated, too.
Mm-hmm. So you may actually feel like you're your same age in that dream, your current age, but actually, psychologically, you're not. The one about your sister, you know, as you said, that's a very defining moment in your life.
Yeah.
And that's a defining event. So it's a way in which you think about yourself on a regular basis. So it's going to occur in your dreams regularly too.
Mm-hmm.
The others the cheating, I mean, when did, do you remember when you first had the cheating dream? Was that with your current girlfriend?
With every girlfriend I've ever had.
Oh, that's interesting.
Every girlfriend I've ever had, and it's always been the exact same thing. I've never known who I've cheated with, or what I did, or how it happened. It's just a fact that exists.
Right.
And sometimes the dream will play out, like sometimes I'll have like, you know, like it'll be like, I have to talk to my girlfriend, I have to figure this out, like how am I going to explain it? Like it'll get deep in that sense, but it always starts from the point of it having already happened.
And
which seems so sad to me.
And the feeling is I've screwed everything up, that's part of it, and that the relationship is going to end.
Yeah, but it's always I didn't want it.
Yeah.
So it does. It never feels like any sort of like cry for help.
And you didn't want to, which means that it, essentially you were coerced into cheating on her?
No, it's not like I'm not a victim in the dream in any way.
Okay.
I just don't know why I did it, which is weird because in my life I don't do a lot of things. I don't really do any things that I don't want to do, or I don't do things I regret much, you know. It's out of character, but it's so intense and so specific. It's almost like another person living in that dream state.
Yeah.
That does that. Really, but but the feeling is so close. Like it's hard to even articulate, but I know that feeling. Like as I'm talking about it, I know that feeling of waking up. It's like I did the thing, I cheated, and now I fucked everything up.
So let's talk about, step aside from the dream for a minute and just talk about cheating and what your association is to cheating in general. Have you ever cheated on a girlfriend?
Once a million years ago.
Mm-hmm. And what was the result?
We broke up, but I desperately wanted to break up with her.
Okay, so it was a catalyst.
Yeah. That actually was a desperate cry for help. And she was mean. It was the right move.
Okay. That's interesting.
Yeah. Yeah. But there's nothing beyond that.
So what's your... What do you think about cheating in general?
I don't think about cheating. I don't really think about it much.
No.
Like, what do I think about it?
Yeah.
I think it's probably a bad idea, but I guess everyone in their own relationship has different parameters.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess the word cheating means something specific. So you're cheating on the deal you made.
Mm-hmm.
So in that sense, it's always bad.
Right.
You know, cheating is a bad word. It's never a good word.
Right.
So it's terrible, but... It's not something I do. I don't really cheat anywhere in my life, I don't think. I'm just more obsessed with the idea of being the kind of person that, when I try to interpret it, I get really fixated on the part where I don't get to enjoy any of it.
Yeah.
And that just seems like it comes from a shitty place.
So, because dreams often... play out in a metaphorical language. So the concrete meaning of that, the concrete storyline of that dream is that you've cheated on your girlfriend. You don't remember how or why, and something bad's going to happen. You're going to probably break up. But if we take it more to a metaphorical level, so it's no longer just cheating on your girlfriend and feeling of doom. And think of it as, I've done something, or I've gone back on a deal that I made with somebody, and it was pointless. It was a pointless act, but it's in the past. I can't change it. And there's something bad that's going to result from it, but I only have myself to blame. So if you think about that, think about it in those terms, what comes to mind?
God, I don't know. I've done something that I only have myself to blame. Sometimes I feel that way about my work and my life and my schedule and, mm-hmm. you know, the amount that I'm not always present for people around me. Mm-hmm. Like, I've done this to myself. I only have myself to blame. Like, I sort of made my bed.
Yeah.
And sometimes it feels vaguely selfish, mm-hmm. but it also feels like a big part of what makes me, you know, work as a human being. Mm-hmm. But that's the closest thing I could think of something that, like, where I feel like I've done this, I'm a disappointment, mm-hmm. kind of stuff.
Do you remember ever feeling that as a kid?
A lot in school. Uh-huh. Constantly.
So, I felt like in what ways?
I was a classic disappointment in school. You know, I got bad grades.
Okay.
Not too much to my parents. I mean, mm-hmm. you know, like a healthy amount to my parents, but mostly to like faculty. And, you know, I was just mm-hmm. like, I didn't do well in school. I kind of acted out. I was like a disappointment. Mm-hmm. You know, by all the standards of what I was supposed to be doing. I went to like a school where half the day was Hebrew and I couldn't do that well, so they took me out of those classes. Mm-hmm. That's a very specific feeling.
Yeah.
I don't think about that a lot. It's very separate from my life now.
Yeah.
Because my work doesn't feel disappointing now. But probably until like 12th grade. Mm-hmm. Like when I tried to go to, like I didn't really get into many colleges. I didn't go to college. I started touring right away. Uh-huh. That was a weird split moment in time where I was really happy making my work and writing songs and playing music and things like that, but I was so unsuccessful in school. Mm-hmm. It's funny to feel like such a failure and such a success at the same time.
Right. So, you know, if that was a repetitive experience for you up until about age 12, then that became probably a significant aspect of your self-image and the way you saw yourself. And so those formative years are really lasting in terms of how you see yourself. It's hard to shed some of that stuff, even if you go on to be successful, you know, in this case, and not mm-hmm. not let people down or not, you know, not feel
I still feel like I'm pulling a fast one on everyone sometimes.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get found out,
right?
And then I have to like do, like, it's sort of the way I treat myself if I have a panic attack. Like, I'll have a conversation in my head where I'll like right. list things like, you know, you did this right. and you did this and, you know, you played these songs and people liked them and,
right.
you know, you wrote them and you didn't fake it or anything like that. So, you know, you don't have to think that you're like a giant fake.
Right.
But that's a constant feeling. I think that specifically comes from like actually being a fake in school.
Yeah.
Like not doing
right.
work or not having read the book.
Right.
And like walking in and being like, I have to like fake
right.
this.
So you see how persistent that self-image is, or that sense
yeah.
of yourself. And so oftentimes what dreams do is they take, if you have sort of a glimmer of a feeling of that in your current life, whatever, what small or large way, mm-hmm. when you dream, your psyche might say, oh, let me take you back in time to where this originated.
Yeah.
Or to a point in time when something similar, you had a similar feeling and this was what it was. And so it bridges, it's like, oh yeah, this is familiar because. So you can be, there can be layers of your own personal history within a given dream.
So the idea of people who aren't here anymore coming to you in a dream state, they're actually coming to you, you're not sort of...
I've never had the experience. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure I would recognize it as such if I did, but I do think that that can happen.
Because it does feel when I do dream about dead people, it's not... It's so... It kind of feels like that in a way because it's so, you know, once or twice a year.
Yeah.
So it feels like these super special moments where it's not, you know, that's what the song is really about is, you know, you waking up thinking someone's right. still there. It was like insanely powerful.
Yeah.
And it's so rare.
Yeah.
It's not like, which makes me feel like I have no control over it. It makes me feel like it's like I'm lucky enough to have it whenever, once
yeah.
a year.
Yeah.
Which sort of feels like it's someone else doing it.
Could be.
Because if it was up to me, I think about it all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah.
Wake up in the morning, go about my day thinking about people I've lost, and that's just like the main focus of my day, kind of.
You do?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Definitely. But I lost, my sister died, and then my cousin was killed right after, and right before that was 9/11, so there was this big moment in my life where I had, like, a huge shift.
Yeah.
And then everything just became about that.
Right.
In a good way and a bad way, right. you know? I think it's important to not sort of leave too much in the past, but also not carry too much to where you're overly complicated.
Right.
But it also happened when I was 18, so it was a really, like, it was a moment when I was supposed to be, like, super nothing matters,
yeah,
you
right.
know, going to college,
right.
like, trying drugs and stuff like that,
yeah.
but I was fully wrapped up in, like, all this loss, so it was just, like, real line in the sand, like, before and after
right.
type thing.
Right, and one of the things about, I think, what 9/11 did for a lot of people, a lot of New Yorkers, a lot of Americans, was to, and I think your personal loss is probably the same thing. It's a paradigm shift in a way from something like that could never happen to me or to people that I know, to something like that could happen.
Something like that could happen.
Something like that could happen. Something like that could happen. Something like that could happen. Something like that could happen.
Thinking you were still here, my hands shaking with regret. I've held this dream for such a long, long time, and I wanna get up to the rhythm of a wild, to the rhythm of a wild heart that beats like a rolling drum. Saw you standing on the corner. I saw you standing on your own. And I get the feeling that it's all a dream. And I wanna get on to the rhythm of a wild, to the rhythm of a wild heart that beats like a drum. When I fall asleep, I can see your face. What I lost in you, I will not replace.
Since you've gone, when I fall asleep, I can see your face. you see me in the darkness, I hope you know I'm not alone. Carry you with every breath I take, and I won't let up, I won't let up, until the wind is gone.
Till the wind is gone. held this dream for such a long, long time. I don't wanna get up to the rhythm of a wild, to the rhythm of a wild talk that beats, beats like a rolling drum. I saw you standing on the corner. I saw you standing on your own.
And I get the feeling that it's all a dream. And I wanna get up to the rhythm of your wild, to the rhythm of your wild heart. It beats like a drum. When I fall asleep, I can see your face. What I lost in you, I will not replace. And I could run away, I could let them down, but I will remember your life,
'cause it follows me in darkness. Hard, but I can't win. I played the victim for a long, long time. And I want to grow up from the rhythm of the young, from the rhythm of the young. The heart, it leaps just like a river runs. Tonight I sit over the parkway. This summer's gone and I'm alone.
And I get feeling that you're somewhere close. I don't wanna get up to the rhythm of your wild, to the rhythm of your wild heart. It beats, been beating since you've gone. When I fall asleep, I can see your face. What I lost in you, I will not replace. And I could run away, I could let them down, but I
aren't random.
A lot of times for me, dreams are way more feeling than a dream.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess there's three main dreams/feelings I have. But the main one I have is I'm somewhere and it's totally nondescript. And so it can be different. It can be like different places, but I'm somewhere and nothing is going on, so I'm just in a room and I don't see anyone, but there, I always know it's a person. So for example, it could be my mom, or it could be a friend or someone I work with or something like that, but I don't, they're not there, so I'm not ever face to face. And it's just this very, very subtle feeling where I'm in a completely nondescript place. I literally can't even describe it. It's not like in the clouds,
right?
It's not, but I just it's not white walls, it's not black walls, it's just in the dream there's no place. All I know is that something is terribly, terribly wrong. I can never see the person or place where I am, but I know who it is. And it's just something is like deeply, deeply wrong.
But it's not specific what the thing is.
It's completely not specific. I can never figure it out. Mm-hmm. And when I wake up from that dream, which I have probably once a week, it can take me anywhere from a few hours to the rest of that whole day to get out of it. And it's like that feeling, like, you know, when you get terrible news and then you forget it for a second, mm-hmm. and you know something's horribly wrong.
Right.
And then you remember, oh, it's because there was that terrible earthquake, right. or so-and-so just got cancer or whatever. Mm-hmm. It's that feeling all day. So that's one main dream.
Okay.
The second dream is a little bit more of a specific version of that dream. I've cheated on my girlfriend. And I didn't want to. And I'm not having sex in the dream. There's no like pleasure component that right. I feel bad about. It's just once again this feeling I'm somewhere, I'm nondescript, I've cheated, I wish I didn't, but I can't change it. And that one is like super potent. I'll wake up with it and I'll be like, I ruined everything. So those two are the main ones, and then maybe like once every 6 months I'll have this other kind of dream. Which is really what the song is about. My sister was born with brain cancer. Uh-huh. She died when I was 18. 12 years ago. Wow. Time. And I have this dream, which is super, super specific. I'm with my sister, who's not here anymore. And we're not doing anything specific, but there's just this, like, there's this vague feeling that everything is okay. She's there. It's extremely real. She's the way she was. She's 13, which is when she died. She's that age. And then what's crazy about those dreams is when I wake up from those dreams, which is really what the song is about, there's this period of time, which I'm really focused on, fascinated yeah. about, where it's probably, in reality, it's probably 5 seconds, but it feels like 1,000 years, right as I'm leaving the dream, and right as I'm fully becoming conscious that I'm in reality,
right.
And that 5 seconds is like, for these dreams specifically, when I'm dreaming about my sister, I'm in reality, but she's not dead. And it's the most powerful experience ever. Because my entire life is based on, I feel like in different people's lives, really intense defining things happen. And so for me, that was, you know, by far the most defining thing that's ever happened in my life. So everything I do, if I like drink a glass of water, if I walk down the street, I'm doing that as someone who lost my sister. That's just, it's like who I am. It's like being Jewish or 6 feet tall, or it's just like a defining feature of myself. And so in that split 5 seconds, I'm not that, and it's like I'm literally a totally different person.
Essentially, in that dream where you're with your sister and she's that age,
yeah.
you actually are transporting yourself back to yourself with her before she died.
Really?
Yeah. So you're in your psyche, you're that person. We can sort of time travel in our dreams, and we often do. So you're that person, which means it feels like that. You are that person before she died, and before that defined who you were.
Yeah, like I'm less complicated, too.
Mm-hmm. So you may actually feel like you're your same age in that dream, your current age, but actually, psychologically, you're not. The one about your sister, you know, as you said, that's a very defining moment in your life.
Yeah.
And that's a defining event. So it's it's a way in which you think about yourself on a regular basis. So it's going to occur in your dreams regularly too. The others, the cheating, I mean, when did, do you remember when you first had the cheating dream? Was that with your current girlfriend?
With every girlfriend I've ever had.
Oh, that's interesting.
Every girlfriend I've ever had, and it's always been the exact same thing. I've never known who I've cheated with, or what I did, or how it happened. It's just a fact that exists.
Right.
And sometimes the dream will play out, like sometimes I'll have like, you know, like it'll be like I have to talk to my girlfriend to figure this out, like how am I going to explain, like it'll get deep in that sense, but it always starts from the point of it having already happened,
and
which seems so sad to me.
And the feeling is I've screwed everything up, that's part of it, and that the relationship is going to end.
Yeah, but it's always I didn't want it.
Yeah.
So it does. It never feels like any sort of like cry for help.
And you didn't want to, which means that it, essentially you were coerced into cheating on her?
No, it's not like I'm not a victim in the dream in any way.
Okay.
I just don't know why I did it, which is weird because in my life I don't do a lot of things. I don't really do any things that I don't want to do, or I don't do things I regret much, you know. It's out of character, but it's so intense and so specific. It's almost like another person living in that dream state that does that. But the feeling is so close. Like it's hard to even articulate, but I know that feeling. Like as I'm talking about it, I know that feeling of waking up. It's like I did the thing, I cheated, and now I fucked everything up.
So let's talk about, step aside from the dream for a minute and just talk about cheating and what your association is to cheating in general. Have you ever cheated on a girlfriend?
Once a million years ago.
And what was the result?
We broke up, but I desperately wanted to break up with her.
Okay, so it was a catalyst.
Yeah. That actually was a desperate cry for help. And she was mean. It was the right move.
Okay. That's interesting.
Yeah. Yeah. But there's nothing beyond that.
So what's your... What do you think about cheating in general?
I don't think about I don't really think about it much. Like, what do I think about it?
Yeah.
I think it's probably a bad idea, but I guess everyone in their own relationship has different parameters. So I guess, I guess the word cheating means something specific. So you're cheating on the deal you made. So that, in that sense, it's always bad.
Right.
You know, cheating is a bad word. It's never a good word.
Right.
So it's terrible, but it's not something I do. I don't really cheat anywhere in my life, I don't think. I'm just more obsessed with the idea of being the kind of person that, when I try to interpret it, I get really fixated on the part where I don't get to enjoy any of it.
Yeah.
And that just seems like it comes from a shitty place.
So, because dreams often play out in a metaphorical language. So the concrete meaning of that, the concrete storyline of that dream is that you've cheated on your girlfriend. You don't remember how or why, and something bad's going to happen. You're going to probably break up. But if we take it more to a metaphorical level, so it's no longer just cheating on your girlfriend and feeling of doom. And think of it as, I've done something, or I've gone back on a deal that I made with somebody, and it was pointless. It was a pointless act, but it's in the past. I can't change it. And there's something bad that's going to result from it, but I only have myself to blame. So if you think about that, think about it in that in those terms, what comes to mind?
God, I don't know. I've done something that I only have myself to blame. Sometimes I feel that way about my work and my life and my schedule and, you know, the amount that I'm not always present for people around me.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I've done this to myself, I only have myself to blame. Like, I sort of made my bed.
Yeah.
And sometimes it feels vaguely selfish, but it also feels like a big part of what makes me, you know, work as a human being. But that's the closest thing I could think of something that, like, where I feel like I've done this, I'm a disappointment, kind of stuff.
Do you remember ever feeling that as a kid?
A lot at school.
Uh-huh.
Constantly.
So,
I felt like
in what ways?
I was a classic disappointment in school. You know, I got bad grades.
Okay.
Not too much to my parents. I mean, you know, like a healthy amount to my parents, but mostly the, like, faculty and, you know, I was just like, I didn't do well in school. I kind of acted out. I was like a disappointment. You know, by all the standards of what I was supposed to be doing. I went to, like, a school where half the day was Hebrew and I couldn't do that well, so they took me out of those classes. That's a very specific feeling.
Yeah.
I don't think about that a lot. It's very separate from my life now.
Yeah.
Because my work doesn't feel disappointing now. But probably until, like, 12th grade. Like, when I tried to go to, like, I didn't really get into many colleges. I didn't go to college. I started touring right away. And I just, that was a weird split moment in time where I was really happy making my work and writing songs and playing music and things like that. But I was so unsuccessful in school. It's funny to feel like such a failure and such a success at the same time.
Right. So, you know, if that was a repetitive experience for you up until about age 12, then that became probably a significant aspect of your self-image and the way you saw yourself. And so those formative years are really lasting in terms of how you see yourself. It's hard to shed some of that stuff, even if you go on to be successful, and, you know, in this case, and not not let people down, or not, you know, not feel.
I still feel like I'm pulling a fast one on everyone sometimes. I'm gonna get found out,
right?
And then I have to, like, do, like, it's sort of the way I treat myself if I have a panic attack. Like, I'll have a conversation in my head where I'll like, right, list things like, you know, you did this, right, and you did this, and, you know, you played these songs and people liked them, and,
right,
you know, you wrote them and you didn't fake it or anything like that, so, you know, you don't have to think that you're like a giant fake.
But
that's a constant feeling. I think that specifically comes from, like, actually being a fake in school.
Yeah.
Like, not doing,
right,
work, or not having read the book.
Right.
And, like, walking in and being like, I have to, you know, I have to, like, fake,
right,
this.
So you see how persistent that self-image is, or that sense,
yeah,
of yourself. And so oftentimes what dreams do is they take, if you have sort of a glimmer of a feeling of that in your current life, whatever, what small or large way. When you dream, your psyche might say, "Oh, let me show you. Let me take you back in time to where this originated."
Yeah.
Or to a point in time when something similar, you had a similar feeling, and this was what it was. And so it bridges. It's like, oh yeah, this is familiar because. So you can be, there can be layers of your own personal history within a given dream.
So the idea of people who aren't here anymore coming to you in a dream state, they're actually coming to you, you're not sort of...
I've never had the experience. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure I would recognize it as such if I did, but I do think that that can happen.
Because it does feel when I do dream about dead people, it's not... It's so... It kind of feels like that in a way because it's so, you know, once or twice a year.
Yeah.
So it feels like these super special mm-hmm. moments where it's not, you know, that's what the song is really about is, you know, you waking up thinking someone's right. still there. It's like insanely powerful.
Yeah.
And it's so rare.
Yeah.
It's not like, which makes me feel like I have no control over it. It makes me feel like it's like I'm lucky enough to have it whenever, once
yeah.
a year.
Yeah.
Which sort of feels like it's someone else doing it.
Could be.
Because if it was up to me, I think about it all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah.
Wake up in the morning, go about my day thinking about people I've lost, and that's just like the main focus of my day, kind of.
You do?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Definitely. But I lost, my sister died, and then my cousin was killed right after, and right before that was 9/11, so there was this big moment in my mm-hmm. life mm-hmm. where I had, like, a huge shift.
Yeah.
And then everything just became about that.
Right.
In a good way and a bad way, right. you know? I think it's important to not sort of leave too much in the past, but also not carry too much mm-hmm. to where you're overly complicated.
Right.
But it also happened when I was 18, so it was a really, like, it was a moment when I was supposed to be, like, super nothing matters,
yeah,
you
right.
know, going to college,
right.
like, trying drugs and stuff like that,
yeah.
but I was fully wrapped up in, like, all this loss, so it was just, like, real line in the sand, like, before and after
right.
type thing.
Right, and one of the things about, I think, what 9/11 did for a lot of people, a lot of New Yorkers, a lot of Americans, was to, and I think your personal loss is probably the same thing. It's a paradigm shift in a way from something like that could never happen to me or to people that I know, to something like that could happen.
Something like that could happen.
Something like that could happen. Something like that could happen. Something like that could happen.